Imagine America at a time when technology is radically changing the entertainment industry and laws banning the recreational use of mind-altering substances are being challenged. That's not just today's world. It's also the way things were back in 1929, when prohibition was the law of the land and silent movies were giving way to high-tech ones where people actually talked out loud. Incredibly, right as the Great Depression was about to hit, the first full-length student film was made at the University of Oregon with a camera loaned to students by the legendary Cecil B. DeMille. Those students shot a romantic comedy known as Ed's Coed. Now, over 8 decades later, a new comedy, Let's Do It, will tell the story behind that groundbreaking piece of cinema and bring it to life with today's actors.
In that era, a camera was high technology, and just to get a hold of a camera gave the students the power to produce the movie. And you look at all the components that are going to go into making this movie; they're vast. And there it was, they got the camera, they got to make the movie. It was a simpler time.
Let's Do It has a screenplay that's a heartfelt, humorous, and even risque romp through a world where students first dared to say that they could make a movie just like Hollywood.
It all began in the fall of 1928. University students Carvel Nelson and James Raley returned from summer jobs working on a film set with a bold idea.
Carvel Nelson and James Raley decided they were going to make a film. Now, they had no experience making a film, and there's no reason to believe that they would be able to do that.
With complete confidence in their ability to do something they knew nothing about, they were able to put things together.
So they wrote to Cecil B. DeMille, innocent as they could possibly be. You know, they wrote to the greatest director of the time and said, "Can you give us some tips on making a movie?"
DeMille was intrigued by the two young filmmakers' nerve. Curious to see what they could do, DeMille lent a camera and his personal cinematographer, James McBride.
On his side of it, were more than friendly to give advice and such, because no students in the United States had ever tried to make a film.
It was really the story of a kind of a naive freshman who came to the University of Oregon, and hijinks ensued.
Let's do it. Let's fall in love.